Our chapter is chapter number 7, given on page number 125 of your book, Internet Basics. In this chapter, we are going to learn about some basic concepts that we can use when we use internet. So these are the internet basics. We will learn some netiquettes, means online behavior. We will learn about email, email address. We will learn how we can send an email, how we can create our account on an email providing website, how can we write blog, and what are the blogging websites that are available, and the last topic, what is podcasting. One more topic that we are going to discuss is Google Drive. How we can save our documents or files on the internet using Google Drive. So these are the basic topics that we are going to study in this class, in this chapter, Internet Basics. So you all use internet. Nowadays we usually use internet for buying anything, for searching anything, and right now we are using internet for learning something new also. We are using internet for e-learning. So we are using internet daily. So there are some habits, or there are some safe surfing habits that we should follow for fair internet usage. Fair internet usage means we should use internet fairly, means without creating harm to anyone and without harming ourselves also. So what are the safe surfing habits? What are the habits that we should follow when we are surfing the internet so that we remain safe? First of all, do not download any free media like videos, free audio, or any free software online, because they usually provide viruses or malware with these free media. They will provide you these things free of cost. You will get the video, you will get the audio, you will get the software, you will get the file, but they will also attach virus or malware with those files. So do not download free media, free MP3 files, free video, or any other thing, as it may be infected with virus or malware. Yes. Next thing is, do not give any person.
What is malware?
Malware is a type of virus. Malware is a type of virus. Okay, that creates problem. Malware actually means many types of problem creating software. Like one virus or one problem creating software will delete all the files from your computer, called sweeper. One is there that will have all the information about you, and then it will transmit that information to any other person. Okay, that is spyware. So all of these combined together are called malware. These are problem creating software. Like spyware will spy on your activities, sweeper will delete all the data from your computer, and there are other problem creating software also. So
it can store data information from a computer.
Yes, that is called spyware. That is spies on your activities and stores your information, your most important information, and send it to someone else. So if you are
have a control on our mobile.
Yes. They basically infect computers and mobile phones.
And they can record our calls also.
If they want. Next thing is, do not give any personal information online. Personal information means your name, your address, your mobile number, your date of birth,
email address.
Your email address. Without asking your parents, if someone is there whom you do not know and they are asking about your personal information, do not give your information. So what will they do with your personal information? they will use this personal information to either create problems for you online. For example, if you have given your personal information to someone, they can create a fake account with your name on Facebook. If you give your personal information like date of birth, they can hack into your account because we usually use password as our date of birth. So if anyone is asking your personal information, do not give your personal information and do not post your personal information online without asking your parents. Next thing is, if you usually use any online service like Facebook or Gmail or any other service, usually change your password and have a strong password. Okay, if you have used one password, then after 2 to 3 months, usually change that password. Okay.
We have to change password regularly.
Regularly, yes. Do not give any payment related information ever. Means if someone is asking your credit card number, your CVV, means when it is expiry, there is one number at the back of the credit or debit card called CVV. Do not give these payment related information yourself because you might get duped. Someone will cheat you. So let your parents handle that. If you want to pay for something, you want to buy any book online or any other thing, do not do this. Ask your parents, they will do it for you. Next thing is, try not to use any public network and computer. Suppose you are in a library and that library is having internet connection. So you should not be using your Facebook account or Gmail account on that network or that computer. It is called public network. Means there are at least 10 to 20 computers connected in the library. So any other person from any other computer can have access to your Gmail or any other account. So if you are using a public network, if you are using a public Wi-Fi also outside, then you should not use your personal information there. So try not to use public network or public computers. Suppose you have used one public computer and you have not logged out, and after some time someone will come and he or she will use your account. So that will create trouble for you. So these are some safe surfing habits that we should follow. Next is netiquettes. Netiquettes means etiquettes, means behavior. We should have a good behavior in our regular physical environment. We should have a good behavior in the school. Now, we have one more area where we are there. At least we spend 1 or 2 hours daily on internet. So while surfing internet, we should also follow some online behavior. So when we are surfing internet, we should follow some certain online behavior. These are called netiquettes or net etiquettes, means online behavior that we should follow or show when we are surfing the internet. First one, we should follow these netiquettes. First one, never abuse anyone online. Do not use abusing language for anyone if you are chatting with someone online or if you are commenting on any post. This can result in cyber crime. You might get punished for this crime. Next thing is, if someone is bullying someone online, someone is harassing someone online, someone is creating problem for someone online, so stand against that cyber bullying. Means you should
Public chats in Instagram.
Yes, public chats in Instagram. Someone is harassing you, someone is writing bad comments against you. So stand against that behavior. So what you should do, you should inform your parents or elders or teachers that someone is doing this. Okay. So take a stand. Feel free to discuss these things with your parents or your teachers or elders. So stand against any cyber bullying. Cyber bullying means if someone is harassing you in the cyber space, means harassing you on internet, in Facebook chats or Instagram or anywhere. Don't spam. You should also follow some good behavior. One is don't spam. Spam means sending unwanted messages to someone. Multiple unwanted messages to someone. So don't spam. That is, don't repeatedly send or post unwanted mail or messages to someone. If you are sending 100 messages at the same time to a single person, that will be seen as a spam. So don't repeatedly send or post unwanted mails to someone. If they want that mail, send it to them. Otherwise, don't do this. That will be taken as spam. Next thing is, write in clear language. If you are writing something, write in clear language. That is now an online behavior to write short form. For example, there is one short form LOL. Right now, there are so many short forms that we use usually. So if someone is not regular on internet, he will not be able to find the meaning of that word. So write in clear language, write clear words. Do not use slang, means do not use abbreviations or small words. Otherwise, the user will not be.
Sir, they will understand
that is the short form. Not have to write if people.
If they are regular on internet, then they will be able to understand it. Otherwise, they will not be able to understand it. Na. So try to convey your message in a clear way. Means use full word. Write in a clear language. Remember that whatever you post online, either your photos or information about you, is public. Anyone can see it, anyone can read it. Previously on Facebook, if you post your photos, there was option that anyone can download that photo also. Now it is secure, but previously it was not secure. So remember that whatever you post online is public.
In Facebook.
Anyone can read it. Next thing is, if you want to have any essay for the school competition, if you want to have any poem for the school competition, or if you are taking any photos from internet, try to ask first and then you can use it. So never steal anyone else's work. Anyone else poem, anyone else essay on the internet, if you are using their work, at least give their name. Suppose I have downloaded a poem from the internet, so I should at least write the name of the writer, that this is not mine poem, this is not my poem, it is poem of this writer. So if you are using anything, if you need to use it, use any image, use any file, use any poem, use any essay, then ask permission for it and give credit to the creator. Right? At least write the name of the creator there, that this person has created this poem, written this essay. Do not steal anything from the internet. Now, what are the threats that are always there on the internet? We should be aware of some potential threats of working online. If we are working online, there are some threats. There are chances that we will get ourselves in trouble. So what are the threats? First one is theft and fraud. Someone can steal our data. Someone can steal our important information. And someone can steal money also. Someone can cheat us also. Digital criminals are there. They may get hold of your personal information. For example, your login ID. It should be login, login ID. So these criminals may get your personal ID and password. If you give this personal ID or password to someone using internet, and they can start using your account, and if they have your account, they may send mail or messages to others on your behalf. The user who will get this message will think that you have sent that message, but they have your login ID and password. So they can send anything to that person using your account, and it will be a trouble for you. Thus,
he has taken money.
Your login ID and passwords are there with the person, and he or she can send anything to any other person using your name. So that is why don't post or give your personal information
to the other people. And
yes, so never post or give personal information online. If you will give your information which are mostly personal online, then using that information they can have a hold on your ID and password.
They can call us also.
And for the security of your account, keep changing your passwords regularly. So regularly change your password. If by mistake someone has got your password, if you are changing the password regularly, he or she will not be able to have hold of your account. They cannot use your account. Next thing is online harassment. There are threats and problems of online harassment also. Someone might harass you. Harass you means they can abuse you online, or they can mentally torture you online, post unwanted comment on your post. These are the things which are taken as harassment. Someone can stalk you online, means someone who is sending you unnecessary message every time you are on Instagram or Facebook, and they are always sending you message. That is called stalking, means following someone, and they are not interested in that person, and they are again and again sending messages to that person. Sometimes you get bullied also. Someone can harass you, someone can create problem for you, someone can post wrong comments on your post. So there are chances that someone might harass you, someone might stalk you, and someone might bully you online. So what you should do? Do not panic, but do the following things. First one, if someone is sending you abusive messages, do not respond to those messages. Do not respond to abusive messages.
Sir, we can block.
Block that person, but do not respond. If someone is abusing you, you should not talk to that person. Take a copy of that abusive message. Take a screenshot. Okay. And bring this information that someone is harassing you, stalking you, bullying you. Bring it to notice of your parents, your elders, or sometimes teachers also. Okay. Keep strength. Do not get perturbed. You should be strong. You should not get harassed or stalked by someone. You should be strong enough to provide this information to your parents. Okay. Feel free to do this. Never get provoked with such messages. Do not try to send those messages again to someone, or do not respond to abusive messages. Keep yourself busy in some productive activities online and stay calm. And if something happens, then you should inform your parents about these things. Next thing is email. Email is a facility. And in this era of pandemic, we are mostly using email. So what is email? Email stands for electronic mail. It stands for electronic mail. E stands for electronic and mail. It is the most widely used tool to send messages electronically, means using computers. To any single individual also,
mobiles, computers,
yes. To individuals, mean a single person, or sometimes to group of individuals on a network. So email stands for electronic mail. It is a method to send messages electronically to either a single person or a group of person at the same time. But these persons should be on a network, means they should be connected to internet. What are the advantages of email? What are the benefits of using email facility? First one is low cost.
cost.
You can say they are might be. You can say they are free, but you have to pay for the internet connection. So they are of low cost. They are very fast.
Very low cost.
Just you will click on send, and someone who is sitting thousands of kilometers
sent.
Far from you will get the message.
It will get sent.
Yes. Waste reduction. If you are using paper and pen and writing any written message and then posting it using post office, then
so
there are chances of waste. Yeah, they can be destroyed also. Yes.
Or it will get many days.
Yes. There are chances of waste also. So you will write 3 to 4 papers and then at the last you will get one paper that is your fresh paper. But if you are typing the email and if you have, yes, if you are writing an email, if you have done any mistake, then you can just erase that mistake. But in paper, you have to just have another paper. So waste reduction is there. If you have done any mistake, then you can erase that message. Ease of record. Every message that you sent is recorded online. So no need to have a record. It is very easy to maintain record of email messages. Record maintenance. Record is properly maintained by the service provider. Like for example, Gmail. Gmail records all the messages sent by you, received by you. It is very easy for the company which is providing the email facility to have a record. Patience. Okay, patience actually means that you do not need to worry about it, that when it will be received by the user. Whenever you will click on send, it will automatically send this message to the user. So no need to worry about the time. Just you will click on send and the user will get the message. So patience. So next thing is limitations. What are the disadvantages of email? First disadvantage is hardware requirement. You need to have computer, you need to have internet connection, you need to have mobile phone, you need to have ID of any email provider. So hardware is required. Without hardware, you cannot do this. Impermanent. The messages are not permanent. When you connect to internet, you get those messages. And when you are not connected to the internet, you will not get those messages. So email is not permanent. But if you are using post, if someone has sent you some message, the messages are there in your home. So whenever you want, when you can view that message, that written message. But here in email, you need to connect to internet, then only you can view those messages. So it is impermanent, not permanent. A hasty medium. Just you click on send and the message is sent. Might be in a hurry you have done a mistake. You cannot correct that mistake after you have sent the message. So it is a very hasty medium. So it is very hasty medium.
Can't delete the message.
No. If you have sent an email, that email will be received by the user. You cannot stop the email from going to the user once you have clicked on send. You can delete the message here in your email account, but that will be received by the user.
We have sent to the user, it will be received by him.
Yes. Hard to convey emotions. One more thing is, it is very hard to convey your emotions. In email, you cannot convey your emotions. What are your feelings? Because you are not physically present there. Nowadays, to solve these problems, we have emoticons, right? Now to solve these problems, we have emoticons. Emoticons that we are emoji, that we are crying, emoji to show that we are happy.
Yes,
like
in WhatsApp, but in Gmail it is not.
Yes, it is available there also. So it is also one benefit of email, one disadvantage of email or limitation of email. Email account and email address. If you are using an email address to send or receive messages, might be you have seen these types of email address. For example, pacasapakasa@hotmail.com, @india.com, @infomeet.com. Right now, you have seen these types of email address. So email account is an account that we create on any website that provide email facility, and they usually give us one email address. Email address commonly takes this form: username, @hostname. Okay, for example, Pakasa is username, @hotmail.com is hostname. Pekka@dell16.vsnl.in. So dell16.vsnl.in is host name. Yes. PACA is username. For example, BALA_GM@india.com. India.com is host name and BALA_GM is username. This one is username, this one is hostname. So it is commonly written like this: username, then @sign, and then hostname. So what is username? On the left side of @ separator, it is always found at the left side. PACA, PACASA, all of these are at the left side of the @ separator, and this is actually our username. A username cannot have blanks. You cannot give a space. For example, BALA and then a space GM is not correct. It cannot have blanks or spaces. Next thing is domain name or host name or server name. Domain name for the host server. It is at the right of the @ separator. The portion to the right of @ separator identifies the server or host or network. This is server, hotmail.com, dell16.vsnl.in, it is the server. India.com, it is the server. India.com, it is the server. It is sometimes also called email server. It is also called email server. Next topic is electronic commerce or e-commerce. We usually buy things online. We, the young generation today, are buying most of our things online. This buying of things online is called electronic commerce or e-commerce. So electronic commerce or e-commerce is the selling and buying of goods or services over the internet. Examples of some companies which are doing e-commerce are Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal, Myntra, Grofers, Big Basket, Swiggy. So how many of these do you know? Amazon, Flipkart?
Yes, sir, I know all. Sir, I know more also.
Some more you can say? Tell me.
Sir,
Zomato.
Big Basket, Swiggy.
Lenskart, Nykaa.
Yes, Lenskart. Yes, very good. There are many websites. Now shopping online. So nearly everything which is available in the market, in the high street or shopping center or in the market, now can also be found online. Everything what you can buy in the market, from the market, you can buy online also. For example, if you don't want to go to supermarkets, they also offer you home delivery of their goods through their website. If you don't want to go to any supermarket in Mumbai or Delhi, you just go to their website and just order from there. If you don't want to go to Pramod in Gaya, you can just open their website and give your order, and they will provide you the order as home delivery. Nowadays you can, yes, Zomato also. Nowadays you can download images, you can download audio song, you can download video song also. So digital downloads are also available. items which you previously bought on physical media, for example CD, DVD, you were buying movies using CD or
Sir,
DVD.
I don't download the songs, I do screen audio recording.
Okay. So these digital downloads are also now available for a payment. You can download these on your computer by paying to the website. So this is shopping, online shopping. What is the process of buying any goods online? So first of all, you open that website. You will get an online catalog. All the products that are available on these websites are shown. So that is actually the online catalog. So you will browse through the online catalog.
What we want to buy.
Yes. So you will browse through the online catalog. Then you will add items. Suppose you want to buy books, you will click on the book and you will add to cart. So these are add to a virtual basket or a virtual cart called shopping cart.
Shopping cart.
Now after you have included everything,
what we like, and finally we can choose that
which after you have added everything what you want to buy, you can have a checkout. Checkout means you can just buy those products and you can go out of the website. Then they will ask you the payment method. Either you can go for credit card, debit card, cash on delivery, or any other method.
Net banking.
You can also
Google Pay.
Google Pay. You can also choose. So you will choose the You will choose the payment method and the delivery method. You want pay on delivery. You want delivery on a particular date. You want delivery after 10 days. That you can also choose. Then you will confirm the order, and then you will get information via email or SMS that your product has been shipped, means they have sent the product. It is in transit. Transport company has taken your product and they will provide you the product after some time. Okay, so next classes we will start with advantages and disadvantages. We will study blog also, and we will study about podcast also. Okay.